So we pulled out, turned north, put the throttles down, hardly nothing happened. The water, the river's going 8 knots the other way, and I can only do 16 knots up. Yeah. And there's just no way that I'm going to make it without running out of gas. There's just no way. I'm not making any time at all. This big old Chrysler engine's just screaming back there, right? Sucking the gas up. So we come back to Greenville, and everybody said, well, you know, you're crazy. You can't. No one goes on the Mississippi River. There's just not a recreational river.
Yeah.
What you got to do is go down to Vicksburg and go to the Army Corps of Engineers and get a big book. It's just a road map of the Mississippi River and the Missouri River, the whole works.
That's right.
Mile by mile by mile. So we hop in the truck and we go down to Vicksburg and we buy this book, and God damn, this thing's sophisticated. This river's had levees and gorges and dikes and stuff built on it for 50 years, and they've never been able to control it. They're all underwater. Most of them are swept away, or there are obstacles or something. So, we're going to go down.
Yeah.
We got the book now. What the hell? Everybody can do it. So I put a couple 55-gallon tanks on the back.
Yeah.
So we could store an extra 100 gallons of fuel. And we got all packed up and ready to go. And looking back, I can't believe it, but I don't even think we had any life jackets. We didn't have any. There was no raft. There was no dinghy. And I don't think we had any life jackets. But anyway, we were fearless, so it didn't matter.
Yeah.
We head down. But the second day, we have to get off the river at night. There's just no way you can stay on that river at night. But it changed course so many times. There's all these little cul-de-sacs off of it from the left and the right. And you can pull around the corner and throw out the anchor and just sit there. It's nice, peaceful. Sometimes it was pure white sand. Sometimes it was 2 feet of mud. Sometimes it was just nasty. But most of the time it was pretty clean.
Nice.
And one day, I'm going down, I'm having my beer, just nonchalantly listening to the stereo. And Judy's up on the upper deck, sunbathing, and she starts beating on the roof. And I step outside and yell up, "What the hell's there?" She says, "Man, you better come and look at this." So I got to go all the way to the back of the boat to get on the ladder, come up the ladder, come all the way forward, and I look across the water, and there's just a ripple of white water all the way across, almost the whole thing, and I'm thinking, holy shit. So I run down, grab the throttles, we're just idling just enough to get the steering so the rudders work. So I grab the helm, turn the thing all the way around, gun the boat wide open, and just kind of stay in one spot there, working my way a little bit up the river, but not much, and I grabbed this book that I hadn't paid no attention to,
yes,
and started thumbing through the pages till I get to that spot, and sure enough, there's a dike 6 inches underneath the water, goes two-thirds across this river. This river at this point was about 3 miles wide. I mean, the Mississippi is a mother. It is huge. We thought, holy crap, man, this ain't going to be no picnic from now on. None of this smoking the joints and drinking beer all day long. We've got to pay attention to this book or we're going to kill ourselves, right? So from then on, we took a little bit different attitude. But
yeah,
it was a wonderful, wonderful trip. Lee had a ball. We caught a lot of fish. We saw floating dead carcasses and telephones and trees. And some spots that river would be 90, 100 feet deep. Sometimes it would be 6, 7 feet deep.
Interesting.
And we got to Vicksburg. We had to have a truck come down to the bank and fill us up full of fuel because there's no recreational facilities for a recreational boat on the Mississippi River. None. Except in Greenville, Mississippi, which really wasn't on the river. It was on the lake.
Right.
So every time you run out of fuel, it's a big thing. And we had gas. If it would have been diesel, we probably could have bummed some from tugboats and stuff like that. But being gas, it was a real problem. But we staged our you know, stops and stuff. They can, we weren't burning much. The engine was just basically, I don't know, it was just a generator, and it didn't move too much.
Right, right.
And we got down to Biloxi. Baton Rouge.
Uh-huh.
That is where Huey Long built the bridge across the river, so nobody could take the big boats up there. They had to unload them onto his barges.
Right.
Well, that's when it really got interesting. So here we were. Well, you think a 50-foot boat is a big boat. It ain't nothing compared to them 400 or 500-foot container ships coming up there. Oh, man, it's scary. But we picked our way around, and and we finally got through there, got down to New Orleans, went by the downtown area, and it was really nice and picturesque. We did it. We were congratulating ourselves, and we turned the corner and headed up toward Lake Pontchartrain, and then there's the Intercoastal Waterway right there, and we took another right and headed to Florida down that way.
Uh-huh.
And pretty soon we came to a marina, Oceanside Marina. It got devastated in the last hurricane. I don't even think it's there anymore.
Oh, really?
But that was a shortcut. The Gulf Inlet right there is where a shortcut.
Calls from a federal prison.
Where the big ships don't have to go up the Mississippi anymore. They come up through there.
Oh, I see.
And we stayed there a year. And we thought it was a real laid-back, kickback place, good place to hide.
Uh-huh.
And there was Customs and DEA and with a bodies found in the water, and it was anything but a quiet little place. But we sold the boat there. I went out and made a little more money, and we took off and went to Tampa Bay to find our sailboat. And now Judy Kay and Lee were turtles. They were used to the water now. There was no stopping us. We were going to go on an adventure. You know, a real big one.
Uh-huh. Very nice.
That's about it for the time.
Very good. Thank you very much.
What do you think?
I liked it a lot.
Yeah?
Yep. August, it's October 1st.
Okay.
And Les Froggy interview. Thank
all
you.
Right.
Thank you very much. That was fantastic.
Okay, I sent you the Pacific City bank robbery.
Ah, wonderful.
Okay?
Yeah, thank you. Take care.